Hey guys, welcome to my channel, and in today's video I'm going to talk to you about my winter skincare routine. So this skincare routine is suitable for all who struggle with dry, dehydrated, dull skin and people who are 30 plus. So there is not much anti-aging going on here, but yes, I would like to throw out a disclaimer that these products have been used by someone who is 35. Yeah, I'm 35 years old. So, before you start asking, this lip color is from Maybelline Superstay Ink Crayon, and this is in the number 55. This is my current favorite, very beautiful, beautiful berry toned color. So, yeah, so let's quickly get on with the video. So, as you can see, I have makeup on. Whenever I have makeup on, I use a makeup remover. Since my skin is very dry, I personally love using either a cleansing oil or a cleansing balm. So right now I'm using a cleansing oil from Muji. So this is the cleansing oil I'm using right now, and I'm going to show you how it works on the skin. It's a really, really good product. It's a really good buy. I think I have this for almost 8 months, 9 months now, probably a year now. I don't even remember when did I buy it. But this is a really good stuff. Muji has a store in Delhi. I'm not sure if they are available online or not, but this product is really good. If you do not find Muji, buy cleansing oil from Innisfree. That brand is also really good. And if you want to buy natural, toxin-free kind of stuff, then do check out Soapworks or Juicy Chemistry. I also have the Juicy Chemistry makeup remover here. Juicy Chemistry products are 100% organic, certified organic, and the products are really, really good. But since this product takes everything off, I take the shortcut and I use this. And to remove my makeup, I use these charcoal pads. These are reusable charcoal rounds, like cotton rounds. These are made of charcoal, I think, charcoal bamboo. And these are really, really good. I bought them from Soapworks. And what I do, I take around, there are two ways of cleansing using this cleansing oil. Either you take it on your hand, in your palm, massage your skin, and then wash it off, or use a damp towel and take it off. Or I like to use it with these cotton rounds. It's less messy. I take around 2.5 pumps, and then I run it through my face, and you will see it takes off makeup like magic. See, my brows are gone already. And it is moisturizing, so if your skin is really dry, use a cleansing oil, because it will not only take off your makeup, but it's also going to moisturize your skin really well. And these charcoal rounds are so good because you can reuse them, so you are not adding to landfills and all, and you're not using those one-time use stuff. So as you can see, my makeup has come off completely. And this cotton round is very soft, so it's not abrasive, it's not harsh, nothing, very good quality. And I have 5 of these, and I use them and then I wash them with my hands. Generally, if I've used right now, I'll just wash it right away. I'll not wait for it to wash in my washing machine or something. No, I'll wash it right away with my hand. Take a little bit of soap or your shampoo, just rub it very slightly and it washes off very easily, and then you can keep it for drying. So, okay, I have applied lipstick on my eyes, as you can see. I'm going to take a little bit of water and going to massage it into my skin. It will turn milky, and then I'll wash it off with water and come back quickly. Now you can see my face is soaking wet. What I'll do next is I will take my facial cleanser. I have been using Sugandha Centella face wash. I don't remember for how long, I think more than a year now. I use it off and on, so I take just one pump. You can see it's like a gel. I massage it in my palms. It foams up a little. See, you have to massage the face wash or face cleanser in your palms to foam it up at least a little bit, and then massage it on your damp face. So your face has to be wet before you apply the face wash. I use it with very gentle hand, like very light motions, very gentle motions. Also, this face wash is very, very gentle. It doesn't sting your eyes, which is something I love, because I have this habit of washing my eyelashes. If I have applied mascara, I love to thoroughly cleanse my eyelashes because I don't really want that gunk to sit in my lash roots and making them fall, because I already have very few lashes. So I'm just massaging my skin very, very gently. So every alternate day I use my Foreo Luna and very gently massage my face for a minute. I have been using Luna for I think more than a month now, and it hasn't broken me out. Previously I was using a cleansing brush from Nashio, and after using it I used to see small bumps on my face. I thought, you know, I'm over cleansing or something, and my skin was not reacting that well to all the whole facial cleansing brush thing. But after using Foreo, I have not seen any such bump or bumpy skin texture on my face. I don't overdo it. I use it every alternate day. You can use it daily if you go out. I don't go out, I stay at home, so my skin doesn't catch that much dirt. So there is no point over cleansing it, and just wash off the face wash. So I pat dry my skin, and can you see it's looking so clean right now? Very clean and very fresh. After this, I alternate between two products. Some days I use bakuchiol oil from Soapworks. I have already used this much, can you see? Even though I use just 4 drops of this. Or I use Sugandha's AHA serum. So I use these on alternate days. I took a break from AHA serum. I was using actives for such a long time that I decided to give my skin a break and, you know, do its own thing, because I did not want to overdo it. My skin is very sensitive. It's dry and very sensitive, so I avoid too many products on my face. So I'm right now for toning, I just use rose water. So I'm using Kama Ayurveda's rose water. I'll pat it into my skin. So why I use bakuchiol oil from Soapworks? This is a plant alternative, or it's a retinol alternative. So if your skin is very dry, sensitive, the dermatologist may or may not prescribe you a retinol. So what it does, it exfoliates your skin. It works on the wrinkles or fine lines, dullness, dryness, very good stuff, but only if it suits you. Retinol doesn't work for me, so I have been trying out this plant alternative. This is a retinol alternative. This is a plant-based product, and it's in oil form, but it is very, very lightweight. I have been using it for almost 2 months now. 4 days I use this, 3 days I use this, because if you overdo AHA, if you overdo actives, your skin becomes really sensitive, you know. It makes your skin sun-sensitive also, the AHA serum, but bakuchiol oil doesn't do that. But this is such a good stuff. Like AHA is, like, this is the first product I tried from Sugandha a year ago in 2019, and it changed my life, I'll be very honest. It has 10% lactic acid, which is like very mild for my skin. My skin is very sensitive, but it works for me. I'm going to use this today because it's been some time. I was at my mom's, so I'm using 3 drops. So just pat it into your skin. What it does, it works on the uneven skin. It works on the texture. If you have bumpy skin, if you have textured skin, it will work on that. It will work on acne, scars, marks, and it will also work on the pigmentation. I had a lot of pigmentation around my mouth, on my forehead. It is all gone because I use this stuff religiously for good 1 year. I took a break of good a month or so, and then I started using bakuchiol oil in between. But I will highly recommend you guys to check out the AHA serum, because this is a really, really fab product. So the day I use AHA, I don't use bakuchiol oil or retinol. I don't know. This is a plant alternative, so this is not like your hardcore retinol. But I avoid using it because I don't want to use 2 actives at the same time. Secondly, once you have AHA serum on, give it at least 15 minutes, then move on to the next product, the next step. So You can either try AHA serum from Sugandha or you can also try ordinary AHA serum. I also had ordinary AHA serum which I used up. But finding ordinary products in India is a really tough task. And Sugandha is an Indian brand. And this, while my skin is absorbing all the goodness of AHA, I'm moving on to my eye cream. I'm not regular with my eye cream, I'll be very honest. Right now I'm using this one from Mom's Cove. This is my current eye cream. So I should be really regular with the eye cream stuff, but I don't know, I always skip it. It's not intentional, but I forget applying eye cream. So I have been using it off and on for more than 2 months now, and I really like the texture. It's very light. So right now I have in fact three products that I love to alternate between. One is Sugandha's Rose Hip Moisturizer. Second is Sugandha's Calendula Oat Cream. Third one is this Oil Shea Yogu Fresh Timeless Cream. So this one is a firming cream. This is a heavy duty moisturizer. When my skin is feeling extremely dry, I go to this one. And when my skin is doing okay, it's feeling happy and nice, I go with the Rose Hip Moisturizer. So Rose Hip Oil is like such a blessing for people with dry skin, dull skin. It's an anti-aging product. And it also works on fading your scars, uneven skin tone, it adds glow. So it's actually a beautiful product. So this is the Rose Hip Oil I'm using from Sugandha. As you can tell by the bottle's condition, I use it like regularly. I take around 2-3 pumps of the Rose Hip Moisturizer. It is very light and it just sinks into your skin. So as you can see, it's already gone and absorbed. And after that, I wait for a good 2-3 minutes and move on to the final step, which is applying a facial oil so that it can seal in everything in place. It can lock in the moisture and all the good stuff that you have applied on your face for the rest of the night. So it's been good 5 minutes. What I do, I take around 4-5 drops of this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And gently massage it in my palm like this and pat it. If I see that my skin has no traces of oil left, it's looking like everything has sunk in really nicely, I sometimes apply a sleeping mask. This is the Innisfree sleeping mask. This is their green tea sleeping mask. And it's a very beautiful jelly texture. What you have to do with sleeping mask, like you can apply sleeping mask twice or thrice a week. And all you have to do is apply a very light layer on your face, thin layer on your face, and just leave it on for a couple of minutes. It will sink in, like a lot of product will sink in, whatever is left on your skin, just leave it on and for the entire night, and it really helps with the overall hydration of your skin. And yeah, that was about it. For lip balm, I generally use Juicy Chemistry Rose Hip Balm, but I don't have it right now with me because I'm filming in a different room. And either Juicy Chemistry Rose Hip Balm or I'm using Yves Rocher Lip Balm. I'm going to link both in the description box. If you're interested, you can give them a shot. I hope you guys enjoyed watching my nighttime skincare routine. If you did, do not forget to give it a big thumbs up. If you're watching me for the first time, please subscribe to my channel. And I'll see you very, very soon in my next video. Till then, bye.